Okay, so before we get into today's episode, you're probably wondering what the fuck is your ear all about, Vaughn? Main thing is that I got a little bit of cartilage removed on Friday. Just a very, very small bit that was a little bit hard, a little bit discomfort when I was sleeping on it and been waiting on it a while. But I've got stitches in it and it's massively inflamed, as you could see. So hence why it looks this size. Hey guys, and welcome to today's episode of the off-season vlog series. Now I've got Peanut with me today, mainly to just detract from the ear scenario, and he's loving life. And most of you'll probably see that Ali's just obviously clearly copied me and got himself a rag doll as well. So this is what you'll most likely expect to see on Ali's vlog. Now you would think that the ear is the biggest news of the past 2 weeks, but in my eyes, it is certainly not. The biggest win or biggest news, I would say, is that I've officially moved from double XL in t-shirts to triple. And that, from a guy's perspective, is fucking awesome. And it feels a little bit like this. But it's maybe not ideal being 6 weeks away from a wedding, having to then buy a new wardrobe. However, the kilt that I got made custom for the wedding, we left a little bit of room up top because I predicted this would happen, because I knew that I was going to enter another gaining phase after I'd cruised for so long. So this morning, I'm sitting at 124 kilos. And for the most part, I'm kind of hovering in the one, two, threes, and things are sort of holding nicely there. Slowly but surely creeping up week by week, but at the same time, like, strength has been pretty nuts. I don't think he's impressed. I think we need to let him down. So yeah, RDLs are now up to 235. Which they've never been up there with that form before. Dumbbell pressing now is up at the, I think it was the 60s. And again, I'd never really been in a gym that had dumbbells above 50, so to be pressing them, and my chest's always been a fairly weak area for me anyway, so to be pressing them is awesome. I'm battling with the hammer strength flat chest press as well. That's now above three plates either side. So all in all, things are going very, very well. As a side note as well, what I should probably mention is that I started training back in Perth 1 day a week. Today was the first time I trained back in Perth since March, since lockdown. Wow, bulking faces in full flow, full effect. But yeah, first time I trained back there with Ali and his client JJ. Really good session, just good to be back in that sort of environment, opposed to I've been training on my own legs since the gyms have opened, and it's been fine, but I just felt there was something missing. And Ali agreed that if we just got the one session in a week, wow, look at that, it's Coco Pops mustache, the one session in a week in Body Academy, we both train a little bit harder and we're more likely both getting more out of it. So looking forward to progressing some lifts there. I'm almost stacking the hack squat, and I've got a number in my head of stacking that for the end of the year, which I'm confident that'll do. That'll be consistent from now on. The machines there are just so much smoother than the, you know, like the Hack at Pure, which was just killing my knees. But it served its purpose. But I'll travel there the once a week and back on the Tuesday, which on Tuesday I don't do check-ins anyway, so it kind of works great from a business perspective. And then on the other days, just train from Exercise for Less. And what I'm having to do some weeks is train 5 days in a row, which from a recovery perspective is totally fucking shit. But at the same time, when you've got wedding appointments and whatnot, and that you need to go and choose flowers and this, that, and the next thing, you just kind of got to do what you got to do. There's nothing else for it. So that being said, things are very, very busy. But good busy. Business is picking up week by week. Not only myself, but Ali and Clara as well. It's awesome to see them just grow and scale every single week. It's brilliant. And Clara's now at a point where she's she's thinking of going fully self-employed. And to be in that position, having just sort of been on the brand just over 6 months while the gyms were shut for five of them, is awesome. It feels awesome to be a part of. She actually has just got engaged. So, Clara, if you're watching, massive congratulations to you. Enjoy planning a wedding. it's not an easy one. So it's not easy kind of with all the restrictions, but hopefully by the time that she gets married, all these restrictions will be over. But 6 weeks time, I'll have a ring on this finger. So these vlogs might not last for much longer. This could be one of the last ones for a few weeks, just because I'll be focusing on wedding stuff. But at the same time, client pickups and getting them set up is kind of taking priority right now. But I will endeavour to do my best to give you these updates. It's not like you usually see a lot of the sort of fitness professionals out there do. They'll have a videographer and whatnot. However, I'm just not at that point at the current moment. There's not enough people invested in watching this 6 foot four lanky Dundonian's journey so far. So stack design, some people are asking about anabolics. I'm running currently 300 milligram of test, 150 milligram of MPP and 600 primo. And all I've done is sort of split that between five jabs Monday to Friday to try and reduce oil volume per jab. And it's working really, really well. Other things to bear in mind, blood pressure is in a really good spot. I am in touch with two private companies about donating blood. Well, it's not donating, they pretty much take a pint of blood away. So do that privately versus doing that for the NHS, because if you're taking gear, technically you shouldn't be donating blood anyway. So I'm looking to do that in regards to my programming, not changing, everything's kind of working smoothly. But that's kind of it, really it for me, guys. These updates are kind of short, sharp and sweet. And I hope that you do get a little bit of an idea of what my journey is about. Of course, if there's any questions, all you got to do, if you want to know more about things, all you got to do is just drop me a DM, let me know. But in the meantime, guys, wherever you are, whatever you do, give it the beans.